Scientists on campus are doing cancer research, and now they're collaborating with colleagues at the University of Arizona. The group recently received a grant from the National Cancer Institute.
Several projects at Northern Arizona University are being funded by the $15.7 million grant. It's a collaboration with the Arizona Cancer Center at the U of A, examining the burden cancer places on Native American populations.
Statistically, it's shown that Native populations actually have an increase in mortality in cancer, so that is a health disparity because most of the majority population is sort of leveled off in terms of mortality.
Dr. Ingram is one of three NAU professors whose research will be funded by the grant. Ingram and her students study the effects of low-level uranium exposure on plants and livestock. The researchers collect samples on the Navajo Reservation near former open-pit uranium mines. The project gives Ingram's group, including several Native American students, a hands-on opportunity.
And the thing that I've found is that because it is a problem that many of my students have, a number of family members that have, you know, either passed or have cancer, that it makes them just so much more eager to be involved. And so it's been a great, you know, tool, not just for training them, but also for actually moving the research forward because they have so much, you know, a bigger passion to get it done.
Students in Allison Adams' lab are also motivated to learn more about cancer and biochemistry. The grant will fund research for the next 3 years. These scientists study yeast as they're trying to determine how cells become cancerous.
The reason we can use yeast is because many of the cellular processes that occur in yeast cells are very, very similar to what happens in human cells. And since cancer is basically a problem of cells with basic cellular mechanisms gone wrong, we can actually study those basic cellular mechanisms in yeast and then take what we learn in yeast and apply it to human cells.
Dr. Adams says using yeast in the lab is a benefit for students because it grows rapidly.
It means that we can do experiments with a very short turnover. So you can do an experiment one day, get the results the next day, and so students really get a lot of experience in designing experiments, getting results, interpreting the results, designing the next experiment. And so I think it's a great training tool for students.
Allie Keller is an undergraduate student who works in Adams' lab. She started as an international affairs major before she fell in love with science.
It's been really lucky to be able to work in lab and do science and learn about all of what that entails and also learn about cancer and the grander scheme of what the research in the lab is doing and how it impacts people in their life. So it's been really nice.
Keller researches fragile sites in yeast and routine breakage, which on chromosomes has been found to cause cancer. She says she's fortunate to be practicing science at such an exciting time in history.
We're limited by, not necessarily by technology anymore, but by our imagination in many ways.
Matt Gage heads up the other Northern Arizona University research project funded by the National Cancer Institute grant. He and his researchers study a protein called SGC, or soluble guanylyl cyclase. It's part of the signaling processes related to cancer, as well as heart disease and a number of other diseases.
Proteins are involved in almost every process in a cell, as well as a lot of other processes within the human body. And so most, if not all, cancer at some point relates to function of proteins. So what we're interested in is what kind of shapes do these proteins assume under various conditions? If you make a mutation, what changes?
Understanding the structural transitions could lead to better understanding of tumor growth and ultimately drugs to treat them. Dr. Gage says work done in the lab can take a long time and is often challenging.
It's not easy and you have to accept a large amount of failure with a large amount of success, but there's nothing more exciting or more interesting than to figure out something that no one's been able to figure out before, to see a molecule that no one's seen or an effect that no one's seen before, and every little thing we do contributes to that body of knowledge that we have.
Each of the faculty members in this grant are working with collaborators at the U of A. The grant covers outreach and training, along with this work being done in the lab.
Northern Arizona University offers students research opportunities year-round.